Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Future Friday. In today's episode, we're gonna take a look at wireless charging for your car. So let's dive right into it. Now, first thing you have to understand, it's like the whole idea of it is very simple. It's simply providing power, as in electricity, not data signal, electricity without contacting. Basically, you don't need to physically connect two things to transfer power. Now, Nikola Tesla is the reason why we have this sort of technology. And if you want to understand this, basic of it is just basically two coils transferring energy from one to another using magnetism. Nothing fancy about it. And it generally relies on AC. So even though you could feed DC power, it will convert it into AC and then transfer it from one point to another. Basically, this is just a transformer with an air gap. So that's the core idea of it. Now, before this thing even became feasible for cars, you have to understand all new technology required what we call test bed, basically where you're going to test it. Like you want to test things in space, you may test your scale in, you know, whatever you want to test in Hyperloop. So for this sort of technology, mobile electronics played a very crucial role. As we became more and more and more and more interdependent on our mobile phone for our daily lives, the fact that they ran out of charge became inconvenient. So the fact that people wanted the technology, you know, market provided the technology, and it applied multiple systems also. Basically, there are many ways to transfer electricity wirelessly. Not all the things have to go through magnetic system. There is another option which we call electromagnetic system. Basically, you could have infrared, that is, you know, sending power. Now you might be like, isn't that more or less like solar? Yes, that is. And the reason why they use infrared lamps is basically so you don't see giant flashlight on rooftop, and that allows wireless transmission. So if all multiple systems allowed us to basically test out the system before going into, you know, large scale mass production. And if you want to understand what kind of use cycle this sort of devices get, you need large sample set. Basically, you can't say, okay, this wireless technology works. Okay, people will ask you, like, how many places have you tested? You say 1,000, yeah, they're gonna laugh at you. Now if let's say Qualcomm says, like, okay, I want to make wireless charging for cars, and the people will ask me, where have you tested? They will say 3 million wireless devices. Now we are talking. So when we are talking about cars, you have to understand things in this way, is that the biggest hurdle, like annoyances, so to say, for electric cars is there is no standardization. There is nothing about electric vehicles that is standardized. Now that creates a very big problem, is simply because nobody can create what we call charging station, because these are just the three plugs that are prevalent in Europe. There are many more than this. So as you can understand, if while seeing this, is like, what? Like one is AC, one is AC plus DC, one is DC only. So suffice to say, it's very complex and hassle. Now this kind of prevents mass adoption, because people are kind of familiar with the idea that no matter which vehicle you have, be it petrol, be it diesel, you go to petrol station and you get your fuel from there. Like, you just have a nozzle that fits. You don't have to do this sort of thing. So people are kind of seeking that old simplicity. It's like, okay, they don't mind the fact that, let's say, you go into your office and your car is in a parking spot and you're like, okay, I'm gonna plug the charger. But again, the moment you are plugging the charger, you're like, wait, what? Which charger do I have? Which charge standard do I have? This sort of hassle makes it kind of difficult for people. Now, even if you, let's say, solve this problem, then it becomes a fact that even though we are used to the fact that we're gonna, you know, plug something in and, you know, charge our vehicle, we are not used to the idea of that it will take hours. We are used to the idea that fuel pumping will take basically a few minutes to 10 minutes max. So we don't have any sort of standard where we can charge batteries for that quickly, and nor we should even try, simply because the capacity of a battery bank is so huge nowadays. You are talking about 100 to 200 kilowatts of electricity can be stored in basically car batteries. Is that to dump that kind of energy that quickly? Basically, you will need megawatt size of transformers per car station. It's not that the energy is too high, just to sustain that kind of burst load, you will need very, very big amount of infrastructure. So that's just not feasible. So we need something simple. Wireless charging allows us that. Now, if people thought of like, okay, if we have wireless charging, why not integrate it into the road itself? This is a small test track. You can see the video down below. And this eliminates a lot of the issues. Simply think of it this way. Let's say you are living in a place A, and place B is kind of far away, but they have a highway link and somebody laid down this track for you. And you don't have to be like exactly precise on this. Good enough is good enough for this. Is that you can simply drive. Let's say your electric car has range of 100 km. That track is, let's say, 500 km. You can go to 500 km and you will have 100% charge left in your car. So this eliminates range anxiety issue permanently if enough road have this. Now, this also allows another thing, that if intercity roads, start implementing this sort of technology, you get what we call basically smaller and cheaper car. Now, cars are very cheap, relatively speaking. The basically battery bank is the most expensive part. Now, you make it small. Why? Because let's say the moment people come out of their home, they go into a road, that road has wireless charging. Boom, you don't have to worry about charging. So at that point, the charge, basically battery pack that you will have, would be only for emergency cases. You should have only range of, let's say, 10 to 20 kilometers or maybe 50 kilometers. It does not need 300 kilometers or 500 kilometers. So this sort of allows for mass adoption by making cars cheaper and more compact. Now, when we are talking about this sort of thing, this is not going to go to mass adoption. This is going to go to universal adoption. Basically, this system flat out beats everything. So let's look at some pros of this sort of system. Basically, this is the first time when we are talking about electric vehicles, is that this actually becomes easier than fossil fuel. Basically, you are driving, you don't have to think about anything. Basically, 100% hassle-free operation you are getting. Just nothing. You don't have to think about anything. Now, what about maintenance? Again, there are very fewer components in an electric vehicle, be it even electric bus. It has much fewer components than a computer, compared to conventional combustion engines. So your vehicle will last longer, since the battery pack is no longer going through complete charge and discharge cycle. It will last longer, and you don't have to think about charging it, because you are at a bus stop, bus is charging, people got on, okay, you went to another place. You don't have to think about anything. Basically, this would be the first time where driving electric car will feel like the next generation, simply because when you go back to from electric car to, let's say, going your petrol burning vehicle, you will be like, wait a minute, do I have to go to petrol pump and pay them? And then, of course, you are still paying for this, but this is completely wireless. Payment is also wireless. There you have to be like, okay, I have to swap card. At that point, it will actually feel like next generation. That experience, that user will no longer feel like they are compromising for something. They will feel like, okay, if I'm not driving electric, I'm living in the stone age. So this is very crucial. This is psychological, undeniably so, but it cannot be understated. Now, I already told you, there is a hell lot of a mess with wired charging standard. Wireless charging standard is kind of a bit more flexible and cheaper cars. That's also, and Japan is also investing a lot of money into this. Are there any consequences of this? Well, the first consequence is obvious. Very, very, very expensive infrastructure, because roads are not cheap. It may look cheap to you, but even if you remove the permit cost that government has to pay for a federal reason or whatever have you, even if you remove that cost, they have to build substructure. On top of that substructure, they have to have water management or whatever they need. On top of that, they will have aggregate base or concrete base. On top of that, you will have that tar road. So we just see a very surface of the road. We don't see the infrastructure that is below it. It is very expensive. Roads, especially highway roads, can be many $100,000 per kilometer to $1 million per kilometer. Like Germany's Autobahn road system, it's like blindingly expensive. So that, on top of that, you want to make it even more expensive, simply because you want to place things of this nature, and this will require maintenance also. It's not road, it's not something you put and forget. You have to update them, you have to maintain them, you have to fix them if something breaks. So it's not a very cheap endeavor. Then now, many of you who are familiar with the electronic vehicle market, that right now the biggest selling point electric cars have is that, even though as of now, as of 2018 and 19, you can buy an electric car which is a bit more expensive, while running it will be cheaper. This will make the running cost go higher. Now, will it be as higher as petrol? No, simply because petrol price is going constantly up. So there is no way that electric car will ever become that expensive. But this will make it kind of harder to justify over long term period. Now, the final nail in the coffin, why I don't think this is a good idea, and even Real Engineering agrees with me, I have provided the link video down below, is that this is super wasteful. Now, when you're talking about 99% efficient, that sounds amazing, but here's the deal: a plug is 100% efficient. When you're talking about transferring power from point A to point B, nothing beats physical connection. nothing. And 99% efficiency, yeah, 98 is best achieved in limited scenarios, and practically we are speaking about 80-85%. Now you might be like, okay, isn't that that big of a deal? And if it was that big of a deal, why we are doing this in our mobile phone? Here's the deal: if all the iPhones that are sold that have wireless charging inbuilt into them, and if you are like everybody started to use basically iPhone and in wireless mode, you are talking about wasting 200 to 300 megawatts of electricity. That's a lot, but not that much. But you have to understand, iPhone or any mobile devices are generally operating in 10 watt range. When you are talking about electric car, it's operating in the range of minimum of 50 to 100 kilowatt. That's a very giant power gap. So if you, let's say for simplicity of this mathematics, is that you have 100 kilowatt hour battery bank in your car, 1% wastage is a lot at that point. That means at every basically 100 charge, you would have wasted equivalent of one charge. Now, let's say 100 charge, you are charging only once a day. That piles up over 100 days, you would have gotten one charge. Over a course of, let's say, 3 or 4 years, you would have gotten extra charges. And as you understand, like if your car started to last, let's say 10 years, you would have wasted a lot of energy. Now, that energy is in gigawatts. Now, again, electrical infrastructure can handle this sort of spike, but you have to burn fossil fuel for that. On top of that, let's say you say, I'm going to go 100% electric on this, you're still wasting that energy. It's like, even though you could build a hydro dam, even though you could build solar farm, you can check my video about solar energy here, is that you are wasting that precious amount of energy to just for convenience. You're not gaining anything tangible. You're just, gaining a bit of comfort. Nothing more than that. It's like half of the issue can be solved with supercapacitor, other half issue can be solved with people changing their behavior. Simply, instead of charging, going to charge station, they simply have to charge in their normal home without needing, super fancy, fast charging, simply because they don't need to. Like, the idea is with electric car is not that you go somewhere to charge it, it's that you simply chill out, and when you come home, you plug it and you charge it. And it charges overnight. Why do people have the idea that you have to go somewhere to charge it? It's just wrong. It's just inefficient way of using the system. Your car is mostly standing still. At that time, charge it. And don't charge it like, every time you have a charging place or charging option, let's put the highest and greatest supercharger. You don't need to. Like, practically speaking. So when you're talking about this sort of structure, you are wasting so much energy that over time, like I'm talking 1 million car. That is not that many cars. Tesla have sold that kind of cars alone. And I'm talking Tesla, Leaf, BMW, Audi, all these things combined. You're talking about 1 billion electric car. Let's say 1 billion electric car wasting 1% of electricity. That's a lot of energy. I'm talking about you can run multiple states of America just on that kind of energy. Per like basically 1,000 car, you will be like wasting energy, wasting, just throwing it away, equivalent of 3 to 4 homes. So it's very wasteful. Like, it's convenience, yes. But is it cheap on the long run? No. Is it cheaper in the infrastructure? No. Does it make sense economically to do so? Yes, to some extent, but it's not basically viable. Because 1% wastage on 10 watt is acceptable. 1% wastage on 100 kilowatt chargers, yeah, that's not acceptable. And that's assuming we reach 100%, 99% efficiency. Practically speaking, in real world test, things of this nature, they only achieve 85%. So you can understand this. This is why I am not, even though this can be done, we have the technology, I'm not very sold on this idea simply because it's not very viable. Like, you are roasting the planet simply because you want a bit more convenience. It's and you might be like, okay, what if I want to do long distance travel on a car? First, why you are doing that? Second, I understand that. I understand the reasons for that. It's just we have to find a better solution. You can check my trolley bus episode here, where we used to have awesome electric bus, then we discarded them. So I hope this video and episode would have made you think, in a different way. I hope you like this presentation and learn from it. If in that case, please like. If you didn't, don't worry about it. You can dislike it. I would urge you to leave a comment on my video, what you want to see in the next episode of Future Friday. Please share this amongst your friends. #FutureFriday. Subscribe. Press the bell icon if you're free. And as always, thanks for watching.